Hello, we're now going to have a look at how you calculate file sizes for text, images, and sound. And for each, there is just an equation to learn. But of course, you have to be able to actually apply this equation with real numbers and real scenarios. So I'm going to give you some examples of this after I give the equation. So let's start with text files. The equation for calculating the file size of a text file is to take the number of bits per character and multiply it by the number of characters you have. ASCII uses 8 bits per character. Unicode uses between 8 and 32. So for Unicode, it'd have to tell you how many were being used. So here are two questions. You may want to pause and have a go yourself before I do these. So a version of Unicode is being used that has character codes that are 16 bits long. So it's telling us that it's 16 in this particular case. In bytes, so that's different from our base unit, which is always bits. What is the minimum file size of a text file that only contains hello? Sometimes these questions will just be a case of you plugging in the numbers and that'll be it. Here, we've got a bit more work to do because I need to give it in bytes. I also am not told the number of characters. So the file size is going to be equal to the bits per character. We are told this is 16, multiplied by the number of characters, which you're not told directly, but we are told hello is getting stored. How many characters is hello? Well, it is 5 characters. So we're doing 16 times 5. Well, 16 times 5 is going to be equal to 80 bits. However, I'm not done yet because the question asked me to give it in bytes. So I've got to go from bits into bytes. There are 8 bits in 1 byte. Therefore, I need to divide it by 8 to get it into bytes. So 80 divided by 8 is going to be 10. So the actual answer is 10 bytes. In question 2, we're told ASCII is being used instead of Unicode. A text file has got 2,000 characters as underlying for key info. What is the minimum file size in kilobytes? So it's not bits like our base unit, it's kilobytes. So a bit more conversion required. ASCII uses 8 bits per character, or in other words, 1 byte per character. So we can potentially shorten this a little bit by using bytes. So if I work out the file size in bytes, that will save me a conversion step. You don't have to do this, you could do it in bits first, then divide by 8, but it would save me a step here. So I can do, well, 1 times 2,000, which is 2,000. If we've got 2,000 characters, each character is a byte, therefore the file size in bytes is 2,000 bytes. How do I convert this to kilobytes? Well, a kilobyte has 1,000 bytes in it. Therefore, I divide by 1,000. 2,000 divided by 1,000 is going to be equal to 2. So 2 kilobytes is the minimum file size of this text file here. Let's now have a look at how we calculate the file sizes for images. And like with text, you just multiply your key terms together. The key terms here are height times width times the color depth. Which, when you think about it, makes sense because height and width are in terms of how many pixels we have. The color depth is the number of bits per pixel. So to work out our total file size, we work out how many pixels I've got. That is what height times width is doing. How many pixels do I have? Then multiply that by how many bits we are storing per pixel. Now, there is one sneaky thing which could get added to this formula, and this is metadata. And we only really talk about metadata in terms of images for whatever reason, but every file, text and sound as well, will have metadata as well. Metadata is data about data. And if a question ever includes metadata in it, all you need to do is work out the file size as normal, then just add on the metadata right at the end as your last step. A lot of the time, it won't include metadata. That's why it will say stuff like, what is the minimum file size? Because they might add metadata on later. If it does give you metadata in the question, you have to just add it on right at the end. So be warned. Let's look at 2 examples again for images. I'm giving you slightly harder ones than you might get in an exam, just so you can get used to the harder questions. Often it will just be a case of substituting in the numbers into these formula. So the first question, an image has 32 colors. It has 80 pixels total and 2 bytes of metadata. In bits, what is our file size? It's probably a good idea actually to just underline some of your key terms here, so you don't forget. Okay, well, what are we given relating to this equation? We are not given height and width, but we are given a total number of pixels. So really, it has covered that for me already. So Python's width, it turns out, is already 80. I've got 80 pixels in total. Now I need to multiply this by the color depth. The thing is, it's not immediately apparent what our color depth is, because the question doesn't say, oh, I've got 4 bits per pixel or whatever. It says 32 colors. Now, this is where, if you're rushing or don't fully understand this, you might choose 32 as the color depth. 32 is not the color depth, because it's not, the color depth is not how many colors you have, it's how many bits per pixel. This does give you the total number of colors, but it's not quite the same thing. So to work out the color depth, you need to do 2 to the power something is equal to 32. So what is that value which is going to make it equal to 32? Well, you might have learned this by this point, just the binary plate of the binary powers. This is 5 bits, because x would be 5 in that case. 2 to the power 5 is 32. If you haven't learned that yet, you could just be doing that sort of manually. 2 to the power 1 is 2. 2 to the power 2 is 4. 2 to the power 3 is 8. 2 to the power 4 is 16. Therefore, 2 to the power 5 is 32. Therefore, the power is 5. Therefore, our color depth is 5. So really, my file size is going to be equal to 80 times 5, which is going to be 400. That is bits, 400 bits, which is what I need to give my answer as. However, I can't forget, but I need to make sure I add on the metadata. That should be the last step of my process. So file size is actually going to be 400 plus 2 bytes. Well, this is in bits currently, so I've got to convert these 2 bytes into bits. 2 times 8 is 16. So 400 plus 16 gives me a final answer of 416 bits. That is my answer here. And I suggest always boxing it or making it really clear, because if you're working out, it gets a bit messy, like mine has just done. The examiner wants to know quickly what the final answer is. It makes their life a little bit easier. In question 2, we're told a square image, meaning it's got the same height and width, has a color depth of 5 bits and a file size of 2000 bits. What is the height of this image? So it's different this time because I'm having to rearrange my equation. We've got 2000 bits is equal to the height times the width times 5. So the color depth is correct this time, it is just 5. Now that leaves me 2 unknowns in this equation, which we can't rearrange for. However, it's a square image, so therefore the height and the width are the same. So really, this is height times height, which in other words is height squared. I'm doing height squared times 5. And now I can rearrange it using just algebra. So to get height squared on its own, I need to do 2000 divided by 5. Well, 2000 divided by 5 is 400. So this is going to be equal to height squared. So therefore, height is going to be equal to the square root of 400. Well, the square root of 400, as it turns out, was 20, because 20 times 20 is 400. So therefore, the answer is 20, because that is 20 pixels. Now, you probably will not get something like that in the exam. It's a little bit harder than you probably would get. However, we could be asked to rearrange. This is just a particular case where I'm trying to trick you a little bit by saying square. It's seeing will you pick up on the fact that actually you need to rearrange and do things like the square root. So a bit harder than you might get, but I'd rather we do the harder ones so we can definitely do the easier ones. Now let's have a look at how we calculate file sizes for sound. Like text, like images, not a hard equation to learn because you were just multiplying the terms together. So this time around, it's the sample rate multiplied by the bit depth multiplied by the duration of the sound. So duration means how long it is, how many seconds it is. So this again makes logical sense, I would say, because the sample rate is the number of samples taken per second. The bit depth is how many bits are used per sample. So the first two terms here give us the number of bits per second. We then multiply this by the duration to give us the total number of bits being used across your whole song or your whole audiobook, whatever it is. So here are two questions which we can practice this on. We first of all need to calculate the minimum file size. That's a clue that we haven't got metadata here. In bits of a 1 minute and 5 second recording, which has a 2 hertz sample rate and 5 bits being stored per sample. That last bit is our bit depth. So file size is going to be equal to the sample rate, which is 2 hertz, multiplied by the bit depth, which is 5 bits, multiplied by the duration. Well, the duration always needs to be in seconds for this to work. And currently it's in minutes and seconds. So 1 minute and 5 seconds is 65 seconds. So let's do this step by step. 2 times 5 is 10. Then 10 times 65 is going to be 650. And the unit is bits here. We're not being asked to convert it to something else. Question 2, a sound recording is 4 seconds long, very short, and is able to represent up to 8 different amplitude values. Well, what is that talking about? The file size is 150 bytes, capital B is byte. Assuming there is no metadata, what is our sample rate? So it's another example where we have to rearrange an equation here. So the file size is 150, but it's in terms of bytes. How do I go from bytes into bits? Well, I multiply by 8. So this is equal to our sample rate, which we're trying to find. So let's do that as just S as an algebra term, multiplied by our bit depth, which we're not told at the moment. 8 different amplitude values doesn't mean our bit depth is 8. A bit like color depth, I need to take a step back and work backwards. Unless it tells you it's 8 bits, if it tells you something like this, we've got to do 2 to the power something is equal to 8, because a bit depth gives you the number of possible different values of the sample, which in other words is the number of different amplitude values. So 2 to the power something is equal to 8, that something is going to be 3. So the bit depth is 3 bits. So I'm multiplying S, it's like a 5, S by 3, and multiplying by the duration. Well, the duration here is just 4. So really, I've got 150 times 8 times 12 S. I'm trying to solve for S. Now let's do that step by step. So 150 times 8, I could whip out my multiplication method and do that on paper, but I might be trying to be clever here and go, okay, 150 times 10 is 1,500. 2 times 150 is 300. Therefore, this is going to be 1,500 minus 300, which is going to be 1,200. That's still equal to 12S. And suddenly now S looks a lot easier to find, because all I need to do is do 1,200 divided by 12, which is going to be 100. So therefore here the sample rate is 100 hertz. So if the equation is always quite simple, don't stress if you don't quite see the numbers you are expecting. You could be asked to rearrange, you could be asked to work backwards in the case of color depth or bit depth. Don't panic, check your answer and make sure you do your working out on paper so the examiner can give you credit for it.